I was doing my super specialization in a very big hospital in Delhi, and a lot of my friends and family used to call me saying that somebody's had a heart attack or somebody's had an accident, somebody's very sick, and they are bringing that patient to Delhi, and could I help them in any way? And sometimes they would never turn up. I would keep waiting for them, and then when I finally would get to contact them in the morning, I would get to know that the patient had died on the way, so they had to turn back and go back to their villages. I'm Shuchin Bajaj. I am the founder director of Cygnus Group of Hospitals. We are a chain of hospitals that provides emergency, tertiary, critical care to communities that do not yet have access to these services, and especially in conditions where the golden hour is of great importance, where you can actually lose your life if you spend too much time on the road while trying to get to the nearest big city that has these services. We have 10 of these hospitals, 7 in Haryana and 3 in outskirts of Delhi, and we are planning to open another 15 more hospitals in the next 5 years. Cygnus is committed to ethically saving lives with dignity, affordability, and quality. It is actually a fireable offense in our company if we turn away any patient due to financial considerations. So we will treat all patients regardless of the fact that they are able to pay or not. My initial budgets would be okay. This month I can buy a glucometer because that is 1200 rupees, so I'll buy it. And nebulizer is 1500 rupees, so I can't afford it, so I'll buy it next month. This is how we started with our hospitals, and started off with one very small one. Then luckily good people joined on the way. We got good backing from people who put their money behind our efforts. Right now we have about 1600 people working for us across our 10 hospitals and our offices, and we've treated more than 2 million patients till now, and we've done more than 50,000 life-saving surgeries. That is some numbers that we're really proud of. Unfortunately, the thing that we do is tertiary critical care. The preventive part of it gets lost somehow in the bandwidth that we have. So it's very important to go to the grassroots and the community and talk to them about prevention, about how to have a healthy lifestyle. This is the reason we lay a lot of emphasis on our camps and on our preventive checkups and on our outreach programs, on patient education. We are having on an average 40 camps across locations every week. It can be anywhere, just a preventive checkup camp where we usually do the blood sugar, the ECG, and counseling of the patients. And surprisingly, we detect 5 to 10 new diabetics every day who had no idea that they were diabetics. I found out about SEED on the internet, and I was very, very surprised that it is such an intensive program where they come and work with the company so much, and it is highly individualized. We realized with the help of the SEED facilitators that at least 25 or at least 50 hospitals is something that Cygnus should look at because the need is so immense. SEED then started working on our value chains. What exactly was that we were not doing right? We've learned a lot about sales and marketing as well. Still, the course is continuing, and we are learning newer and newer things. Some people say that if you try to travel on two boats, you'll definitely sink. So you should choose which boat you need to be in. So either you become an entrepreneur or you stay a doctor. But I feel that if I stop being a doctor that I am and stop being clinically involved with patients, then I will not really understand the need of the patients. I'll be just looking at the hospitals from a 30,000 feet level. So you have to go down to the grassroots, see the patients, talk to them. The best I feel is when some of my patients get well and have a smile on their faces again. It's much better than any other numbers on Excel sheets or any reports that I can produce. It is all due to all the friends and the investors and the backers and the doctors that work with us, that the team that has kept the belief in spite of all these ups and downs and the struggles that we face on a daily basis. But it's been something that I would do over and over again if I get the chance.